keep the secrets of different bills. Hey, don't condemn me, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Went from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt. They try to bring me down, see me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is your man, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, listen, before we get too far in this video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like, and let's try to get this video to at least 1,000 likes, okay? That would definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't already done so, please make sure you subscribe. I am by far the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community. I have literally uploaded every single day since 2K20's preloop, and I have been double uploading every single day since 2K21's preloop. So hopefully you can appreciate that 9 a.m. and that 4 p.m. upload every single day, and you can show that by dropping a like and subscribing, all right? Now, let's get into this video. So today we're gonna talk about the facilitating finisher. I'm gonna make it from the small forward perspective. I did make it from the point guard perspective, and a lot of y'all asked me to make it from the small forward perspective. So that's what I'm gonna do real quick for y'all. Obviously with the facilitating finisher, you wanna go with this pie chart here. This is basically like, you can make the facilitating finisher from this pie chart too. If you want this version, let me know in the comment section. I can, you know, obviously work that out for you too if you want me to. But I honestly believe that going this pie chart, the blue and yellow is the version that I think is just kind of the better version for it. But in the grand scheme of things, it just depends on preference. And that's why it's like, it's either or. So if y'all want me to drop it from the shooting and defense perspective also, just let me know in the comment section. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna go with the balanced pie chart. With the facilitating finisher, a build that is trying to get contact dunks, you wanna go ahead and value strength. I know a lot of people do not value strength, and that's perfectly fine. But the individuals, the nephews and nieces that have actually made a build, maxed them out, and had strength, you can tell a big difference on your contact dunks, okay? How many activate and how bumpy you get, all right? Now, what we want to do here is we actually want to drop this down to 83. We want to max out your driving layup, your driving dunk, and your standing dunk, okay? Then we want to max out our mid-range, our three-point shot, our free throw, and then we want to get our post fade to 47. And the thing is this, it sucks because I really want to max out the post fade and don't really want to do anything to the free throw. But unfortunately, maxing out the free throw gives you more badge upgrades, and that's what really sucks about it. So, you know, it just sucks because like I don't play Pro-Am. I don't play rec, so I don't really need free throws. But if I was to max out free throw and not post fade, I don't get anything for it. And I can actually show you that in a second, all right? So we'll max out pass accuracy, ball handle. Then we're gonna max out our perimeter defense, our lateral quickness, our steals, our defensive rebounds, and then the rest for the blocks, okay? So that'll give you right at 7. So just real quick, let me go back and show you what I'm talking about. If you max out the post fade and that's it, you only get 6, right? You max out the free throw and then put the 2 here, you get 9. So it's like, whatever, man. We'll go ahead and give you free throws, even though I do not play rec or I do not play park. So hopefully, you know, 2K can kind of work that where free throw and post fade has the same value. Because to keep in mind is that some individuals do not play rec and some do not play on park or my career. I mean, on rec, my career, or pro-am. You know, they're strictly in the park all the time. Well, we don't need free throws. You know, we don't need a free throw when we're playing park. So hopefully they know they can find some way to distinguish that on next gen. Maybe they already did, so who knows. But right now we're looking at 16, 9, 22, and 7. I think this is a really good badge stack lineup, I'm not gonna lie. I really, really, really like this build. The downside, of course, is gonna be the shooting. The build's not gonna be able to shoot like that. So let's just go ahead and call it what it is. It's not gonna be able to shoot like that. So if your expectation is for it to shoot good, it's not gonna happen. 2K has definitely adjusted that, and I like it a lot that you're not able to shoot well with something like that. You need to have an 86 three ball at least to green consistently. Anything below that, you can expect full whites, okay? Now, full whites can go in with the help of flexible release, so there is some boost to that, but for the most part, you don't expect it to go in. You wanna go 6'7", get your the 229 pounds, and then go your wingspan to 87. Don't max it all the way out. And the reason being that I said don't go all the way to 89 is because for one, it drops your ball handle to a 78, you don't want that. And then two, when you go from 87 to 88, it drops your mid-range to a 69. We don't wanna do that. At an 87, you do have your driving dunk at an 85, so you already have all the pro dunk animations, so it doesn't necessarily mean that. Your ball handling is a 79, so Obviously, you have to be a 96 overall to get the pro dribble animation, so that's something to keep in mind. But when you look at your physicals, you do get a +8 to everything, and you get a +4 by hitting 99 overall in the park, or my career, or whatever it is, just hit 99 overall, you're my player. And then the second +4, you can do it by doing three of these things. You can either A, hit superstar 2 in the park, you can B, play at least 40 games in my career, sim out the season, make sure you win a championship, you'll get the gym rat that way. Or C, which most people do, is just go to the Gatorade facility, do well on the equipment every 7 days, and you get +4 that way. So what you're looking at is an 87 speed, 85 acceleration, and an 89 vert, and a whopping 77 strength, okay? So I think that's what really sets this build apart. It's very balanced all the way around in the physicals. And then we look at this finishing, shooting, playmaking, defense slash rebounding. You get a +4 also that way. So you're looking at an 89 driving dunk. You're looking at a ridiculous 92 standing dunk, all right, which I think is going to be very beneficial here. You have a 74 mid-range. You have a 67 three ball, which I said, like, you know, you're going to need a lot of badges to really shoot well with that. So just keep that in mind. You also have an 83 ball handle, and you have an 87 pass accuracy, which is good. Defensively, you'll be okay, but for the most part, you're going to be average. 79 perimeter defense, 76 lateral quickness. You'll have a 63 block, and then you also have a 75 defensive rebound. So all in all, it's not that bad. Obviously, we want to go a slash and takeover here. Some of y'all might want to go playmaking takeover, which is cool, but it's really not. Since the build can't shoot, yeah, you can break an ankle, but they're already going to be playing off of you, right? So they're not going to be playing on you because they're not going to be scared of you shooting a three. Playmaking is really powerful when they have to play up on you because they're scared that you can shoot a three on them. When a build that can't shoot, they're just going to play off. You're not going to get the ankle animations, so you want to go slashing. So hopefully that can help some of y'all nephews and nieces out on that, all right? Then, of course, you have the facilitating finisher. Let's go ahead and test this build out. Let's get in the 99 real quick, and then, of course, we will get y'all out of here, all right? So let's get in here. All right, so here what you want to do is, of course, you want to go contact finisher. You're 6'7", so don't worry about Giant Slayer. Fancy footwork, slithery finisher, contact finisher, and acrobat, okay? So these are the ones. Oh, and then relentless finisher, all right? So these are the badges that are really, really good. You have two gold badges you can pick from. Me, personally, I would go with the slithery finisher and the fancy footwork on the gold. But as you can tell, this is going to be a really, really powerful badge finishing at the basket, all right? Now, here's when the creativity really has to come into play. Range extender is not as effective unless you're 2 or 3 feet behind a three-point line. So you have to look at 2K last for that. So that really changes a lot as far as where I want to put these badges at. Yes, I do want to get hot zone hunter, okay? But what I also want to get is I want to get catch and shoot, and I want to put that on bronze. And then I also want to get my flex release, and I want to put that on silver. Green machine is only effective at gold and Hall of Fame. You're not able to do that as much. And also, you're probably not going to be getting a lot of consecutive greens, so it does not make sense to get green machine. Okay, so then you ask yourself, what other badges would make sense here? And for me personally, there is not really much that can really make sense here other than going to looking at volume shooter on bronze, which you get the best bang for your buck on bronze. That leaves you with two badges left over. And again, like I said, I thought about what could really benefit this build the most, what could really help it out. And honestly, I just decided to go ahead and go with bronze in the corner and then also get another boost to my catch and shoot. So you're probably saying, like, yo, you're the primary ball handler. Why are you working like this? Well, the thing is that, you know, most of the time they're going to play off. When you pass the ball, just move around, get to a spot in your hot zone, catch and shoot it, hopefully in the corner. Flexible release will help out and get you there. You just got to be very, like I said, sometimes you got to be creative with these things, man. You want to go handles for days, quick first step, obviously. You want to get dimer or floor general, pick one, right? Then you'll go space creator, ankle breaker, right? And then I would go downhill. And I know a lot of y'all gonna be like, downhill? Well, I play a lot of threes, and I like to get the rebound and go coast to coast, okay? So that's the way I do it. But like I said, I get my badges based upon my play style, so it's really up to you, right? And then last but not least, clamps, intimidator, and then chase down. And that's what I would go with, all right? So there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the facilitating finisher. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and as usual, your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon, another banger, man. And you know, when I say I'm back soon, another banger, you already know what day I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.